Thanks for tuning in to the Unsafe, Outdated Food Preservation Methods module. I am Megan Baumler, recording for Suzanne Dreesen, University of Minnesota Extension Food Safety Educator. Where do you get food preservation information? According to the National Center for Home Food Preservation, 51% of home food preservers rely on family and friends for recipes and information. Grandma may be sharing what she learned from her mother, which is now outdated. There are lots of scary and unsafe methods on the internet, too. Using credible and reliable food preservation resources is critical so that no one gets sick. A National Center for Home Food Preservation survey found that 55% of respondents used their canning instructions as is, while 31% adapted the instructions for their personal use. Adapting recipes is risky and can ultimately affect processing times and even the method of canning. For safety's sake, follow canning instructions and recipes exactly. Using recipes from canning publications or cookbooks dated before 1994 will be underprocessed. The National Center for Home Food Preservation survey found that over half of home canners are underprocessing food in canners. Underprocessing results in risk for botulism. Use current research-tested canning recipes and resources. Consider using the Complete Guide to Home Canning by the USDA or the So Easy to Preserve book from the University of Georgia. There are lots of other websites, blogs, and videos on the internet. Make sure they reference research-tested recipes, otherwise don't use them. Credible websites include the National Center for Home Food Preservation, ballfreshpreserving.com, or university websites. Canning recipes found in old cookbooks and canning books use open-kettle canning. The open-kettle method isn't really canning, because you put hot food into jars and seal with a lid without additional heat processing in a canner. The National Center for Home Food Preservation study found that 44% of home canners open kettle fruit and tomatoes, 35% open kettle vegetables, and 20% open kettle meat or fish. Open kettle is very risky. Further processing in a canner is needed to destroy disease and spoilage microbes in the product. Reliable food preservation resources instruct you to heat process your food product in a boiling water bath canner or in a pressure canner. Botulism is a concern with low-acid foods like vegetables, meat, and fish. These foods must be superheated in a pressure canner to destroy spores that cause botulism, a potentially deadly foodborne illness. The inversion method instructs you to put hot food, like jam or tomatoes, into a jar, cap it, and then turn the jar upside down for a length of time. This is risky because spoilage microorganisms are not destroyed by further heat processing in a canner. The product will likely spoil during storage. Lids may become unsealed due to low vacuum or gases produced by spoilage. Turning the jar upside down can actually break the seal. Heat processing freshly filled jars of fruit or preserves in a boiling water bath canner is needed to destroy heat-sensitive bacteria or spoilage organisms. Another unsafe and outdated method is to melt and pour paraffin wax on top of a product to seal. This is risky because the wax can shrink, crack, and allow airborne molds to grow on surface and throughout the product. Throw away jams and jellies with mold on them. The mold could produce mycotoxins, poisonous substances that can make you sick. USDA and microbiologists recommend against scooping out the mold and using the remaining jam or jelly. When in doubt, throw it out. Make sure the equipment that you are using is designed to safely preserve food. Appliances like ovens, microwaves, and dishwashers are not recommended because the heat transfer does not reduce the risk of disease or spoilage microbes. Also, be aware of new equipment options available on the market, like electric pressure canners, which have not been researched. The National Center for Home Food Preservation does not recommend them, because they are a pressure cooker and not a pressure canner as advertised. Now you know what methods are unsafe and why. For safety's sake, use and share science-based and safe food preservation resources and methods. Thank you for watching.